Sésamo y el autismo. Enfrentar los desafíos.
Careful, you don't trip. I'm Cindy. My husband is Jem. We have two boys, Thomas, who is 8, and Ryan, who is 7. And Thomas is our son, who is on the spectrum.
Dad!
I know.
Dad!
Thomas is a great guy. He's full of joy. He brings a lot of energy into whatever room he comes into. But Thomas will run away. He doesn't understand danger, and he'll leave. When he was about 3 years old, I went down to put a load of laundry in and came back upstairs and Tom was gone. He had gone up to our backyard and our neighbors found him. So we started asking every professional we knew, what can we do, what can we do? And then we randomly ended up at a workshop where the head of the program was speaking about service dogs, and we thought, this is it, this is the answer for us. 2 years later, Thomas was 5 and we met Gabriel, and since then, everywhere we go with Tom, he goes with us.
Ready? Come on.
Tom's tethered to Gabriel wherever we go, and so Thomas no longer can bolt. He also likes the job, so if Thomas is trying to pull away, I'll say to him, remember, you've got to bring Gabriel, and he enjoys that, that's his job. Tom's relationship with Gabriel isn't like a typical boy's relationship with a dog. At home, he doesn't interact with him as much as Ryan does. But that's okay with us. That's just a different relationship than other kids have. But Thomas, when he's under stress out at the store, he'll go closer to Gabriel. So I think he understands that Gabe's there for him. It's a balancing act between accepting Thomas for who he is and keeping the bar high for him. Because if you lower the bar, he definitely won't hit it. In our town, they hosted a race for just kids, and they had regular heats, which were for kids to go over the obstacles that Ryan did, and then they did a special needs heat, so Thomas actually competed in that as well, and they both got to do something together. Ryan's definitely been seeking out like times with his brother that they can do stuff together, so he was really pleased that Tom ran the race. That was nice.
1, 2, 3.
Ryan will ask, why can't Thomas talk? And so we always just keep it very simple and say it's because he has autism. I definitely think that it's really important for the typical sibling to know what's happening, but in a way that protects Tom's dignity, because, you know, I'm talking about Thomas to Ryan. He's there and he understands what I'm saying, so we're very careful about how we talk to him. And we also ask for help. We've asked our therapists that work with Tom, like, hey, what do you say to a typical sibling? Because it is a big issue. The advice I'd give to parents of typical kids with siblings is to talk to them about it so that they're not sitting alone with that, and just make sure that they can talk to you about it.